have seen how to solve the forward kinematics problem and inverse kinematics problem for serial manipulator. To gain confidence, like how to assign the coordinate system, how to carry out the forward kinematics, how to carry out the inverse kinematics. In fact, we need more some example, more practice, and that is why actually I have taken, I am just going to take two more examples just to explain it again, like how to assign this particular the coordinate system, because this is very important to assign the coordinate system correctly. Now, if you can correctly assign the coordinate system, then we will be able to find out the kinematics equation correctly, and once the kinematics equations are made correct, then only we can find out the correct dynamic equation, and control is based on the dynamic equation. So, the accuracy lies with actually how to assign the coordinate system correctly, and that is why let us spend some more time on how to assign the coordinate system, and let us try to spend some more time. And let us try to solve some very simple example. Now, this is one example, example of one manipulator, the serial manipulator having only 3 degrees of freedom. For example, say this is the fixed base. So, here I have got one twisting joint, say T, and I have got one sliding joint, that is S, and I have got a revolute joint, that is R. So, this is nothing but a T S R manipulator, and its kinematic diagram, very easily we can draw the kinematic diagram. For example, say this is the fixed base. So, I have got the twisting joint here, then I have got one sliding joint. Now, this particular sliding joint is denoted by this particular symbol, then we have got one revolute joint, and after that there is one end effector. So, this is nothing but the kinematic diagram for this particular the manipulator. Okay. Now, let us try to assign the coordinate system once again. Now, to assign the coordinate system, as I told, the first thing you will have to do is you will have to concentrate on the reference coordinate system. So, this is z x and z cross x is y, and the first joint. So, this particular joint is the twisting joint, that means this will be rotated and z will be along this particular direction. So, you select this particular as z naught, okay, and this particular x naught you try to take in the same direction of the reference. So, this is your x naught, and y is nothing but z cross x. So, this is your y naught. Okay. Now, you see here we have got one sliding joint. So, this particular with the help of the sliding joint, so it can move up and down, and this is a linear joint, and this particular linear joint it will move along this. So, my z 1 will remain same as in the direction of z naught. So, this is my z 1 direction, okay. And here, so what you can do is, so they are on the same line. So, z 1 and z 2, they are on the same line, and along this I take this particular x 1. Now, I take along this as x 1, so that I can show this particular dimension, because they are on the same line, and if I do not show x 1 here, so I will not be able to capture this particular the dimension. So, let me take x 1 here, and if it is x 1, then y is z cross x, then comes your this revolute joint. Now, for this revolute joint, so z will be different from this particular z. So, let me take z 2 along this particular direction. That means, this is the z 2 direction. So, this is the z 2 direction. Okay. Now, here, so this particular z and that particular z, they are intersecting. So, to select this particular x, so I have got in fact both the options, but I selected this particular as x 2. so that I can capture this particular dimension, because this particular coordinate system I am just going to copy it here and show that the mutual perpendicular distance to the 2z, that will be your the length of the link. That means, we will be able to capture this particular the c. That is why, instead of in this particular direction, so I have selected x 2 along this. Now, if this is z 2, this is x 2, then z cross x, this will be y 2. And as I discussed earlier, the same thing will be copied here, and this is actually the hypothetical joint. So, z 3 will be this, x 3 will be this, y 3 will be this. So, this is the way actually we will have to assign. So, this particular the coordinate system. Now, once you have assigned this particular coordinate system according to the DH parameter setting rule, now what you can do is, you will have to prepare the DH parameter table. And to prepare the DH parameter table, so what you can do is, so once again the DH parameters table frame 1, 2, 3, the same sequence like theta I, d I, alpha I, a I. The first one, the first joint is actually a twisting joint. So, definitely the variable will be your theta 1. Then comes your d. Now, you see the d is the distance between 2 x. So, this is x naught, this is x 1. So, this is the distance between 2 x and it is measured along z. Okay. So, this particular a is nothing but an offset, but this offset is a fixed offset, and that is why this is shown as a star. So, this particular a star is the fixed offset, this is not the variable offset. Okay. The next is your alpha. So, alpha is the angle between 2z. So, the 2z's are lying on the same line. So, the angle between them is 0. Then comes your a I. A I is the distance between 2z measured along x. The 2z's are on the same line. So, here, so this particular alpha is 0. Now, next is your 2. That is 2 with respect to 1. So, 2 with respect to 1. Okay. Now, here, so this particular joint, for example, this particular joint is a sliding joint. So, the variable will be the offset. So, offset will be the variable, and here the theta, that is your angle, that is your joint angle, that will become equal to 0, because this is a sliding joint, not a rotary one. So, here, so this variable offset, that is nothing but v, and that is the distance between x 1 and x 2 measured along z 1. So, this will be the variable offset, and theta is equals to 0. Now, if you see this particular table, in place of theta I put 0, in place of d I put b. Now, this particular b is actually the variable offset. Then comes your alpha. So, here, so this is z 1 and this is z 2. Okay. Now, if I draw the z 2 here, if I draw the z 2 here, say this is z 2, if I draw, then z 1 to z 2. So, z 1 to z 2, so this is clockwise, so this will be your minus 90, and a I is nothing but the distance between 2 z, but they are intersecting. So, the distance between 2 z is 0. The next is your 3 with respect to 2. Now, here, so this particular joint is actually a revolute joint. So, definitely the variable will be theta 3. Now, then comes your d. D is the distance between 2 x. The 2 x are lying on the same line, they are collinear. So, the distance will be 0. Then comes your angle alpha, and alpha is the angle between 2 z, they are parallel. So, we will be getting 0 here. Then comes a I. Now, this a I is actually the distance. AI is actually the distance between 2z measured along this particular the x, and here you will be getting c. And you can see that all the dimensions like a, b and c, we are able to capture a, b and c. Okay. And now, once you have got this particular thing, the way I discussed, very easily you can find out the forward kinematics. And once you have got that forward kinematics equation for the known matrix, for the known position and orientation, you can carry out the inverse kinematics. Now, as I told, it is very easy, like how to find out the forward kinematic solution, like your T 3 with respect to 0. So, this is nothing but T 1 with respect to 0, then comes T 2 with respect to 1, T 3 with respect to 2. Now, T 1 with respect to 0, so this will give actually T 1 with respect to 0, this will give T 2 with respect to 0, this will give your T 3 with respect to 0, with respect to 2. And if you multiply, then you will be getting this particular final, the 4 cross 4 matrix, which will carry position and orientation information. So, this is the forward kinematics, and by following the method, actually you can carry out the inverse kinematics the way I discussed in the last two problems. You can follow the similar type of approach to carry out the inverse kinematics. So, this is one problem. Now, just to gain more confidence, like let us try to look into another similar type of problem, but slightly different. Now, here I am just going to consider another serial manipulator. So, having 3 degrees of freedom. So, this is nothing but the 3 degrees of freedom, 3 degrees of freedom serial manipulator. Now, here we have got the sliding joint first. So, this is S, then we have got the twisting joint, that is T, and here we have got the revolute joint, that is R, and this is nothing but actually STR manipulator, STR manipulator. Okay. And following the same method, first you look into that particular the reference coordinate system, and before that you can also find out very easily the kinematic diagram. For example, say first we have got the sliding joint. So, this is actually the sliding joint, then we have got the twisting joint, okay, and after that we have got the revolute joint, and then we have got the end effector. So, this is nothing but the kinematic diagram. And once you have got this, now you are in a position to in fact draw this particular the coordinate system at the different joints. Now, this is a twisting joint, sorry, this is a sliding joint. So, z will be along this. So, I have taken z naught along this particular direction, x naught is along my base x, y naught is along my base y. The next is this particular twisting joint. Now, for this twisting joint, once again, so z 1 will be in the same line of z naught, okay, and let me put this as x 1 and this as y 1, so that I can capture, so this particular a value, this particular a dimension. Okay. The next is next joint is the revolute joint. So, this is nothing but z 2, and once again the way I discuss, to capture this particular C information. Now, here this particular z and that particular z, they are intersecting. So, I have got both the options as x 2, but I am going to take this as x 2, so that I can capture this particular the C. It is very simple, very similar almost, but slightly different. So, using this actually now, we can form the DH parameters table. For the first one, the first joint is actually a sliding joint. So, here theta is equals to 0, and here the variable is nothing but is your a. So, A is nothing but the variable, and this is the variable offset. So, A is the variable offset, alpha is nothing but 0, alpha is the angle between 2z and that is 0. Then comes A I, so A I is the distance between your 2z, they are on the same line. So, here A is equal to 0, so we can find out this. The next is your 2, that is 2 with respect to 1. Now, 2 with respect to 1, this is a twisting joint. So, theta 2 is the variable, and then there is another offset. So, this is x 1, this is x 2, the distance between x 1 and x 2 measured along z 1. So, this particular b is the offset, but this is actually the fixed offset, that is why we have used b star. Then comes your alpha. Alpha is nothing but the angle between 2z. So, what we do is, here we draw this particular z 2 the way I did earlier, then z 1 to z 2 is in clockwise sense. Okay. So, very easily actually we can find out. So, this is minus 90, and A I is the distance between 2z, they are intersecting. So, this is equal to 0. Similarly, you can find out this particular thing also, because this joint is the rotary joint, that is a revolute joint. So, theta 3 will be the variable, okay, and d I, the distance between 2x, they are on the same line. So, this is 0, and alpha, they are parallel. So, alpha is 0. Then comes your A, that is the distance between 2z, and that is nothing but is your C, and your, so this is the C. So, you can prepare this particular the DH parameter table, and as I told, once you have got this particular DH parameter table correctly, you can carry out the forward kinematics, and if you know the final position and orientation, so very easily you can find out the inverse kinematic solution. But here, if I solve the inverse kinematic solution, we will have to solve for theta 2, theta 3, and this particular the variable A. Okay. So, if I want to solve the inverse kinematics, so in inverse kinematics here, inverse kinematics, the variables which we are going to find out are your theta 2, theta 3, and your A. So, these are actually the variables whose values are to be determined. Okay. So, this is the way actually we can carry out your the forward and inverse kinematics. Now, once you have done this kinematics, we know the movement of the different links, the movement of the different joints, but till now we did not consider the reason behind this particular movement, that there could be a force, there could be moment, there could be torque. So, those things we did not consider in the kinematics, and those things we are going to consider in the dynamics. But before I go for this particular dynamics, so we will have to discuss another thing, another very fundamental thing, that is called the trajectory planning. That I am going to discuss next. Thank you.